honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, today. We thank God for being here. We thank God for each and every one of you that are here today. We thank God for all the ministers, brothers, all of those that are present today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're just glad for this chance and this opportunity that the Lord has granted unto us. We thank God for how he has kept all of us over the dangerous highway, not allowing any hurt, harm, or danger to come upon us, but allowed us to be in this place to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. We're certainly glad for all. We're glad for the beloved ministers. We thank God for the elders and all.
Amen.
We thank God for them all. We thank God for the brother, Mr. Kevin, Mr. Brother Kevin. Yes, sir.
Charlie.
Charlie? Right, Brother Charlie. We're glad to be here. Thank you, Jesus Christ. And we thank God for all of your wives, your children, all of you that are here present in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God for Brother Sherman. We're certainly glad for him. We're glad for his children. Also glad and thank God for Cliff, Jeff, their family, and sisters, and all of you that are here present today. My daughter is here, and that's my family. We're glad that the Lord has blessed us to be assembled here. Thank God for our neighbor, Ms. Mims, who across the street being able to be here. Where's Tony? See, he should have been here too. I get it. Okay. But we're certainly glad to be here. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we thank God for allowing us to be here. We thank God for all that the Lord has done, allowing us to be assembled together, all the sisters, all the mothers, everyone. We thank God for all of you that are here present today, sitting before the Lord to hear those things from God, so that we will know what to do, how to do, what we need to do in order to be saved. Because our whole objective is, we want to be saved, right?
Amen.
That's the bottom line. We want to obey what the Word of God says. The Word of God is the explicit information given to us from God so that we'll know what we need to do in order to be saved. Is that right?
Amen.
So regardless to what man say, think, or may do, we thank God always for the Word, the thing that gives us what God would have us to know and to do to be saved. Some things don't agree with us. Is that right?
Amen. Amen.
Food is good, isn't it?
Yes. Amen.
Food is good in the natural. Amen. But sometimes it don't agree with it.
That's right.
That don't mean it's no good.
Amen.
It's just that our system is somewhat complicated.
Amen.
Ain't nothing wrong with food. Not unless it's poison or something. No, but when it's a good food, sometimes it can be us that we can't digest. Is that right?
Amen.
But sometimes the Word of God comes. And sometimes we as being who we are, sometimes can't digest what the Word says. But one thing I can say, the Scripture says, great peace have they that love not all, and nothing shall offend them. That's a blessing, isn't it?
Amen.
You know, we can get the Word of God and hear the Word, though it may beat us up, though it may hurt us, you know, and do what it needs to do. I heard one minister say years ago, we thank God for the Word. We don't get mad at it because the same word, we could have been killed.
Amen.
Because the Lord said, I wound, I heal, I kill.
Amen.
So thank God is a loving God to kill somebody. Well, he's who he is. He can do that. He can do it and be justified.
Amen.
Ain't that something?
Amen.
He can, no, we can't kill nobody and be justified. Not now.
Amen.
But he can kill somebody and be justified in what he's doing.
Amen.
But now we can't do that because we're not God. But he knows, and the reason why God can do the things he does is because he knows the heart of man. See, we don't know man's heart. We don't know what's in man. But by God knowing what's in man, then he can judge man anytime. He can do what he wants because he knows the end of the beginning of things in man's life. So man may say, well, I'm going to do this or do the other. But the Lord really knows us.
Ain't that a beautiful thing? Amen. That's why it's good for us as a people to strive to be what? Honest. Is that right?
Amen.
Honest to who? Ourselves first.
Amen.
Then honest to God. Then the Lord is able to help us. So we're glad for this third Sunday being here. And we said we're glad for those from the South Florida. For a lot of them, glad for those that are still from further south. My brother Mitchell from, I believe, Ocala, is that correct? Amen. About 30, 40 miles an hour. We call it a stop, a jump and a stop.
And that never stop.
A jump or whatever you want to call it. Is that right?
Stopping the hill.
Stopping the hill. You know what I'm talking about. But close by. Close by. But we are secure in the heart. Yes. But nevertheless, we're certainly glad for all of us being here. We just thank God for all things in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're going to hear the word of God from the Elder Sherman today in the name of Jesus Christ. And after Elder Sherman, we will have some words from different ministers if they so desire. You know, if you so desire, you can get up and, you know, give a testimony and, you know. It's always a time, man. A lot of times you'll be at a big service and they say, well, we want to give each minister 2 minutes.
Amen.
And usually they go over.
Yes.
But I like to be in a point of where it's being obedient.
Amen.
You know,
amen.
I don't think you have to give a time. They just have enough discretion within
themselves.
They say, well, the man who preached already,
right.
I didn't want to give a time.
Amen. Amen.
You know, your time will come.
That's right.
Amen. Is that right? Your time will come. Oh, they get these things right here.
Amen.
Well, I tell you, these things do something to you. But you learn obedience. You learn that.
Right.
Right. Somebody say, give you 5 minutes. That don't mean you got to take it all.
Amen.
Somebody, you get somebody 5 minutes, they going to go, they may go 10 or 15.
That's right.
So I got to sit down now and they stay up another 3 minutes.
That's right.
But nevertheless, it's all about being obedient then.
Amen.
We're certainly glad for everyone that's here. This is my hometown, Gainesville. I was a bit here and left here 30-some years ago in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. My man and my wife, we moved to Tallahassee. But this is where I came up in the church, seeking the Lord, calling Jesus, all right here. It's been some remodeling done since we first opened. But we thank God that the building is still here.
Amen.
A lot of things went on, but God still blessed us in the name of Jesus Christ. So we thank God for this. This is a place of worship.
Amen.
To come and to be able to give God praise. And hopefully people within the community and other areas around here will be able to know that there is a refuge place.
Amen.
A refuge place where they can come and hear. See, when you walk in the door, we all about truth.
Amen.
We ain't all about pocket.
Amen.
We all about truth.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
We ain't trying to see how much money we can raise. We ain't letting the soul be
saved.
Amen. Amen. We thank God and I know this work down here to do within the community and this desire and things that I have. Maybe one day as the time progresses, brothers, we'll be able to get down and pass out some trucks, walk in the community, do something on the yard where people can see, you know, that we're here. Because at one time, the doors were shut for a long time. And people call me even right now, saying, you want to sell the place? You want to do this? Do you want to sell it? You want to buy it? Mm-hmm. One guy said, I'll buy whatever price you want. Mm-hmm. You know, that's cheap. So, you know, like, the man said, you buy something for any price you want. Come on now. Do you know what I want? You know what I want. I might want 300,000. But you said anything I want. Is that right? But we thank God that we're here. We're glad for the saints sacrificing. Coming here,
amen.
We hope that the Lord will bless us more when we can come. We still have work to do here. We got to get the AC, that's right. Doors open, Sam. But this is the way it was a long time ago.
Amen.
This way it was a long time ago, you know. Man, people open up the heights up the windows. Open up the door, turn on the fan. But see, we done got comfortable now.
Yeah.
I mean, if it ain't right, we want it. We don't feel the door is right. But we got to go back to the old landmark.
Amen.
There's nothing wrong with suffering.
That's right.
We got to remember that. Ain't nothing wrong with, I know we live in an age now where we want everything comfortable. We got to remember, suffering is what the Lord said that we have to be able to do. Is that right?
Yeah.
He suffered in the flesh. Yeah. Scripture said what? Arm yourself likewise with what?
The same mind.
Yeah, I need to get comfortable and think it's no suffering, but that's the way it is. So we're glad. I thank God for the rain today,
amen.
The overcast, for the rain in my heart. Suddenly, y'all know, this ain't bad. This ain't bad for us, is that right?
Yeah.
This is all right for him. So I'm glad for the overcast rain. We got some fans we could open that door right there. It won't hurt nothing. Is that right?
Yeah.
But we're glad to be here. So I'm not going to detain any longer, but we're glad for each and every one of you. May God will bless you. I'm presenting to you now my beloved brother, Elder Sherman Hayden.